Hi there. Well, I'm in the town of Hama, or near the town of Hama, which is a place that the province here has seen a considerable amount of fighting and also still has a big presence of the group Jabhat al-Nusra, which is, of course, the Syrian option of al-Qaeda here. We're on the road here with Russian forces. They're going to some villages where apparently there are some reconciliation programs going on. Now, the Russians are telling us that despite the fact that they announced a couple of months ago that they would have a major drawback of a lot of their forces from Aleppo, from Syria, they still do have considerable air power here in the country. We were at Russia's main air base near Latakia earlier today, and we saw jet after jet take off. They say they were policing the ceasefire. Of course, there may have been some bombing runs as well, so certainly the Russians still very much involved in a full-scale military operation here in Syria. One of the questions I pose to the Russians is, what can happen next in Aleppo? Because everybody is so concerned about it. Secretary of State Kerry has called on the Russians to use their influence with Bashar al-Assad to try and make sure that his aerial campaign is at least curbed somewhat. The Russians, for their part, say they have no influence over the Syrian Air Force. They also said that they believe that the reason why the ceasefire in Aleppo isn't holding is because Jabhat al-Nusra keeps shelling neighborhoods that are held by the government. But they also say that they are in a very close talks with the U.S. to try and get some sort of cessation of hostility in that area as well. It was interesting to hear the Russians say that, in general, they believe that the cooperation between themselves and the U.S. here on the ground in Syria, and probably more importantly, in the skies over Syria, is working better than ever, Zane.
So, Fred, you mentioned that despite the fact that the Russians are supposed to be withdrawing, there is significant air power that they still have there. Just explain to our audience, what exactly is Russia's endgame in Syria?
Well, that's actually a very, very good question. And it's certainly one that at this point in time the Russians have been struggling to answer and haven't really been willing to answer yet. It seems as though at this point in time they are supporting the cessation of hostility. They say that they're supporting the political process that's going on with the United Nations. However, of course, there have been breaches. The ceasefire seems to be all but unraveling in many places. So the big question is, do they believe that Bashar al-Assad would be able to take back all of Syria? Do they believe in some sort of political process that could mean the end of the rule of Bashar al-Assad? I spoke to a very senior Russian official actually in Russia a couple of days ago about this matter. And he said that they believe that for the time being, from their vantage point, that Bashar al-Assad is still the person who has the strongest military behind him. So he's the one that they're going to continue to support. However, they also say that if the Syrian people don't want him there anymore, then the Russians would obviously not support him either. But the big question is, how do you measure the support of the Syrian people? Impossible to hold any sort of elections here at this point in time. So right now, it is a very good question. Very difficult for the Russians to explain what their endgame here in Syria might be.
So, Fred, is it then fair to say that Syria's political future pretty much depends on the Russians?
Well, I'm not sure it totally depends on the Russians, but I would say that at least the Syrian political future is one that won't be decided without the Russians. At this point in time, the Russians clearly have the strongest force in the skies over Syria. They have the strongest. They are the strongest supporters of Bashar al-Assad on the ground. He also still has the Iranians, and of course, the Hezbollah as well. But at this point in time, any sort of effort to try and reach some sort of political agreement, any sort of effort to try and reach some sort of transition process here in Syria, is not going to happen without the Russians. And it's something that they feel. It's something that they also make very, very clear when you speak to them.